Right, welcome back, Dragons. As you can see, Dolly has given birth at last. Five healthy puppies. Went very well and everything else, so very, very happy with it. And this was done with an outside male, a dog called Bo Brit from Croatia. So it was a long trip over there, and we got a little Croatian bundle, as it were, moving on. And very, very happy with them. They're good weight and a good feel to them, you know, you can tell. And it went very, very well, and Dolly was very calm, relaxed with it. What we were talking about earlier, I mean, the reason we're going outside now is because we can't really improve on our mortality rate. We've worked very, very hard on the health, the character and the conformity over the years, and we've basically got them all to a level we like. But what we're doing is bringing our lines in closer, and as I said before, what we've noticed is the closer we bring our lines in, the healthier our dogs get, and that's line breeding and the whole idea and concept of it, and it does work. That's why we're proving it, we're trying to prove it and show you what we're doing and why we're doing it. But there comes a stage where at some point it's not going to work, and what we've done is double the blood, and so when there is a problem, you're going to get double blood, triple, quadruple. It's very, very difficult to change something because the blood lines are so strong. So rather than keep strengthening our bloodlines, we're going to take slightly different direction. Our bloodlines aren't so strong that they can't be worked with, and we feel that's important because, as I say, at the moment we've got a mortality rate and everything's based on that. A low mortality rate means healthy dogs, and we can't improve on it, so therefore the only way it can go logically is up, and the closer we get, at some point we're going to hit a plateau where we're going to go up. And I'd rather not hit that plateau. I'd rather not hit that level and start now and just move slightly out. And it might take a couple of years by going out to get back to where we were or where we are now, but we're going to have far, far more options by doing so now and give us far, far more scope in the future, I feel. And if it takes a couple of extra years, then so be it. What else is there to do in life, as it were? You know, I mean, we're not in a rush here. Breeding is a long-term project. And breeders, you know, are thinking 5-10 years ahead all the time. And as I say, if it takes a couple of years longer to get to our goals, at least we're doing it in a way that keeps our dogs healthy. And that's what has to count more than anything else, especially for the people that are taking the dogs. They've got family pets, they don't want sick dogs, and we don't want to be developing any strange diseases. And that is one of the drawbacks to line breeding. It becomes inbreeding, but when it becomes inbreeding, at what point, we don't know. It's never been scientifically proven. We're just using our logic. We can't get any better with the mortality rate, so therefore we move. Outbreeding, outcrossings. We're not going for anything exotic here. We're just going for dogs that are proven, tested, etc., etc., that aren't that far away from what we're doing and where we are. Not totally, totally different. And the reason for this is because something brand new, there's just as much chance you're bringing in something bad as well. And we don't want that either. For example, I was talking about the genetic testing that's going on. And one of those tests was DM, the other test was MDR. Now, MDR has been around for close on 150 years. It became apparent and noticeable in the 70s when with the deworming drugs and the drugs that the companies, the pharmaceutical companies, were pumping out to dogs. And it became apparent then. And then they've developed a genetic test for it. But it came from one particular dog, a herding dog from England. One particular dog is where MDR came from, stems from, and over the years it has spread to all the herding dog breeds, the MDR mutation. And that's the trouble with it. New bloodlines doesn't necessarily mean it's all healthy. There could be something there as well. So we'd rather use dogs that are tried and tested to that, but also match our females. Yeah, because we are going in a certain direction, and we believe that Bo Brit, the father of this litter, is a Croatian dog, and we do believe it's a good match for Dolly. And that's what we're looking at, and should be fun. I'm looking forward to bringing them up and playing with them and seeing the direction we can take them in. And the same with Shiva's puppies as well. We've got a mythology that's laid out now, and we'll be using it. And basically that's it. So we'll be following her progress and Shiva's progress in the future.